Okay, first you want to go to the QX website and download the app for your device. The app for your device, Scio, Eductor, Eternal, Indigo, etc. Okay, so you go to QX site, type in the qxsubspace.com in the address bar above, and then hit enter, and you should come to the site. Then you go over here and click my account. And then put in your information, and you go to downloads. And so whether you have a Eductor, Scio, Indigo, Eternal, or QXCI, you click on what you have. I have the Scio. And you'll see the various things you can download. There's the QX app right there. That is basically the base software that for your device. The QX app is the base software, and they have the various service packs for 5.5, 16, 8.8, 14, 5.5, 14, and then also language packs, video add-ons, etc. I am just sticking with the basics here. And then you'll choose the driver that you need. Maybe you have a serial or a USB. There's a client backup tool. This client backup tool is probably something that's pretty old. I'm not sure, because when I installed this one, it automatically backed up my clients. Didn't really ask me. And so anyway, here's the big program was automatically added to my program. I'm not sure. I didn't download it, but it was automatically added. This is the video kind of program, biofeedback interface, graphics program, and anti-smoking manual, and so the DivX is for the body viewer. And if you have a problem with your body viewer, download that and run it. Quantum prayer manual, Scio users manual, Eternal software user manual. So that's where you get your stuff from. And then you, after you've downloaded the app, then you want to download the service pack. And I have chosen the newest service pack to have the newest software. And once you've opened the app and run it, you want to run the service pack. And it will take you through various screens and lead you to the QX website to verify your information. So if you have a problem with your software, you go to control panel, and then you go uninstall a program. And you'll see several programs up here. Eductor 64, SQ Lite, and let's see, I think the app is okay. You could uninstall that as well and then re-download it. So basically, if you have a problem, what we're doing is we're just wiping a clean slate and then starting all over again. Once you've paid for your software through whatever means, the program will close and restart, and then the program will be activated. And then you'll be able to start the software and then go.
It's mandatory that they get up to par on their most updated software before they can put this software in. Is that correct?
Well, they at least need to get to the new software. Now, let me explain for the people. The new software is not mandatory. If you don't want it, you can keep your old software. There will not be a shutdown next year. The government has not mandated that we make any change.
Nice.